So a new feature in Keynote version 7.2 is an expanded workspace or canvas. What does that mean? Well, you've got this space that's outside the slide, so this area around here. And this won't be visible when you're presenting on a screen, but you can still use it to put objects and do things. So in order to use this, what you want to do is you want to go to the Zoom button here in the toolbar, and you want to make sure Fit Slide is turned off. You also want to turn off Auto Center. Now you notice there are scroll bars here and I can scroll around and I've got lots of space around the slide. I can also zoom out, so like 75%, and have more space. And you can hold the space bar as well and drag. So lots of ways to get around and use this canvas here. Now you can use it for storing things. So for instance, say I've got a slide in my presentation and there's an item in here and I'm not sure if I want to use it or not. If I delete it, well then if I decide to put it back, I've got to bring the element back, resize it and all of that. So instead what I can do is I can simply drag it away and put it off to the side here. This is a common thing that graphic designers do a lot in their tools, and now we can do it in Keynote. So when you present the slide here, all you'll see is this area. You won't see that there's this thing off screen here. But it's there and available for you to put back very easily. You can have a variety of different elements out there as you're working to build your presentation. So that's one use. So another thing you could use it for is to make it easier to do animations. So for instance, I've got this clip art of a plane here. It's just one of the default shapes and I want it to fly across. Now without having the extra space here, I've got to kind of start it on the slide so it appears and it flies and it kind of disappears. It would be nice to have it start completely off the side. So let's animate it first. I'll go to animate here. I'll do an action, add an effect, and select move. And this will give me the line to animate. So what I'll do is I'll have it start all the way off to the left here. Now here's where I run into kind of an issue where I need more space. And you can see as I drag it actually pulls away. I can make it a little easier on myself by zooming out and I can actually put it out here. And I'll have the other point go off the screen as well. So I can have it go from off the screen on the left to off the screen on the right. So now when I try to play it, it gets more of the effect that I wanted. And of course you can do more complex animations with this as well, and just to have a lot more freedom to what the animation is going to look like by using this off-screen space.